Hello again. So happy you could join me on this beautiful day. I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. I'd like to start out by thanking all my viewers and subscribers. I really do appreciate it. And I always try to get back with you as soon as I possibly can. Today we got my standard that I like to use, 16 by 20 canvas. What I did was I went to your local hardware or hobby shop, picked up some different colors of spray paint, sprayed them on there. But make sure you're in a well-ventilated area and you have a mask on. I waited for that to completely dry, then I loaded it up with a thin coat of liquid clear. A thin coat. That's going to help the oils blend a lot better on the canvas, and you won't see, if you miss a spot, it'll drag. So it's better to cover the whole thing with a thin coat. Today I thought maybe I'd do a moonlight scene, maybe with some beach, maybe with some waves coming in, maybe a green-blue ocean. And any colors and all the information you'll need to paint along with me, if that's what you choose to do, will come across the screen somewhere right about here. So like I said, we already loaded it up with a thin coat of liquid clear on this brush here. Went over the whole canvas. You don't want to put too much on, because if you do, it'll start running. And we don't want that. Or you can do the traditional way. Take a blank canvas and put liquid white over it, and then that way your colors will blend right in with the liquid white. I'm going to start off by using we'll use this brush right here to put the moon in. And the moon, I notice, it's more of a cream color, this color here, instead of a white, if you look at it. I'm going to load it up on both sides. Come in here and determine where we want our moon to be. And we can put it down here. Start out smaller and you work your way around. Till you want to get it the size that you think you want your moon to be. Doing is pressing, starting at the top and coming around, pushing down all the way across. You can blend that in. I think I want our moon to be bigger. Around, you can get a perfect circle. Make that a little bit bigger. Step back. I kind of like that look right there. I use odorless paint thinner. It's always a good thing. I'm going to come in and I'm going to fill that moon in. Another little brush like this here. I'm going to load it up and I'm going to tap that. Get that look. All that little stuff that the moon might have on it. Craters and stuff. Fan brush just like this here. We'll get some mist going around it. And what I noticed, the mist was almost had a orange look to it. The orangey look. Just a little bit. Here and there. I'm just tapping this. I'm going to come in to some white. Strictly white, but not a lot of it, just like that. And we'll come in and we'll pull around that color. Glisten look. Wipe off that brush and come in with a dry brush. Just with the edge of it, pull it out. Just with the corner. Have all kinds of little things happening. Little rays, sun or moon. could it be brighter and fade away? Brighter, closer to the moon. Something like that. Fades completely out. Looks pretty bright. Now we're going to start putting some stars in. We're going to use the bottom of this. We're going to get some liquid clear, tap it, and come into some white. Just some white on the end of it. Up some little stars. I'm just kind of mixing it right on here. What I'm going to do is just take a dab of it, circular, and I tap it. You see that little spot? That way you can determine how much and how thick you want it to be your stars. Okay, we got that. Let's go start putting some stars in. We can put quite a few in. And all over. It'd be a starry, starry night. Just keep loading it back up. Circular motion on there, just taking that edge. Make some of them brighter. Put them in clusters, just the way you would see it in the sky. Way to look at it. There's thousands of them. There's quite a few. Is what really makes it. Gives it that. Nighttime. Looks pretty. night. Got some off in the distance. And the more you tap, it takes it away from it, and it makes the stars even smaller, so it gives it that three-dimensional. Off in the distance. Kind of look. Let's put some up here. Some in here. Step back and look at it and say, yeah, it looks pretty starry night. Got a bright one down here. We can give him a friend. So it won't look so. Some over here, I think. I'm gonna stick with that. And all we used was the opposite side of the brush. Now we're gonna come into some. I'm gonna use this brush here. I'm gonna load it up with some green, like a phthalo green, phthalo blue. Get an ocean color. Load it right up on both sides. And we're going to come in here and determine where we want our horizon to be. Muffle that in, blend it in. Come into that moon color, put the reflection down in the water. I think we'll put the reflection down in the water. Let's take that same brush we used, the one with the chiseled edge, get that circular. And determine where we want it to be. Maybe right here. Maybe right down there in the water. Then we'll come in. We'll use this brush here we use for the... We're going to soften this horizon. to be real bright. Just want to give it that look. See where we're at. That's about 7 inches. That's not quite 7 over here. Bring that up. Brighter in there. Okay. Now let's see. We'll measure that. Now we'll come in with the fan brush. I'm going to soften this back here. All I'm doing is tapping this. Have your horizon and have it being misty. All I'm doing is tapping that. ablative can go right up into there. Blender brush, it's real soft. I'm gonna come in and we'll blend this up. We'll blend it right up. Diffuse that. Fan brush, and let's pull this out, make it misty around it like we did the moon. Bringing that moon in. The reflection. They had some white back here. Color with that green. So I'm wiping that brush off some and I'm going to pull it down and through here. Here and there. Use some of the lighter colors in there. corner of your brush. Going straight across. Get some lines of the water. Darker. Then we'll come in and we'll highlight. Highlight with some different colors. You got purples in there and all kinds of colors. Now we'll come back into the palette knife. We'll load it up with some white. And highlight. Straight across. Different colors in there. Now, back here. Be brighter right here. Tap it harder. Pull that back with the fan brush. We'll pull that back. Pull back. To the other way. Get some more white. I think we'll pull back this way back here too. Keep loading it up with some paint. We're going to pull back from that. We're going to pull back from that paint. Same way. Same angle. Take it from the white and pull it back. Get that wave look. Like they're coming in right there. Maybe that's more foamy there. Step back, say, yeah, looks good. I like that water, how it's brighter right in here. And you got the reflection of the moon. Down in the water. I think I'm going to grab some more white here. Highlight this right here more. Sharper where that wave is. Distant waves. Maybe that comes all the way over. These get pushed back real nice. Looks like there's some nice waves coming in there. I'll always add some more white and pull that back from that top of there. Make it more foamy. Beachy area in here. Maybe we can come into maybe a water line. Something in here. But let's put some reflection down first. Get a little bit of yellow, I think. Green color. Come in here. White. Tap some of that white in right here. And pull that one down. Get the blender brush, pull it down. Grabbing it right from the top of that wave. Like that. That is sharp edge there. Maybe it's real foamy. Keeps coming right down. Grab some more white. Highlight this some more. Make it brighter. Tapping it. Let's get some land coming here, I think. We can put some stuff in there. We'll use this brush here. We'll come into some brown and some green. Green color. Palm tree. Mix that up for the palm tree. Then we'll mix up some blue color. Nice. think. Blue and white. Same color as we did the... Get that look of the... Lighter tan color. But maybe to the blue side. Or... the beach area. That looks like a good color. Reflection color. I'm going to leave some of those highlights that are in there, the darker blues. Use them for shadows. And we'll come in now to the blender brush. Shadows are already in there. We'll leave those there. We'll put more white down here, I think. We'll get the little fan brush. We'll put some white in there. Lighten it up right where the moon's hitting this. Touch of yellow. Brighten it up. More white, more yellow. Into the blender brush. We're just going to tap that. Step back. Got that yellow hitting off there. We'll put some palm trees in. We'll use this brush right here to do the palm trees. And I think the palm trees would be a brown. Lighter brown. Just like that. Maybe we can come in and we can put one here. Taller one out here. like that on that angle. Palms in. Liquid clear into that green. Come into some different colors and see what we got. Load it right up just like that. Maybe and highlighting some of the branches or the palms. We might darken it up just a little bit. Clear. loading it up and just tapping it with the corner. Kind of one branch at a time. Come into the other one. The other palm tree. Tapping that. As big as you want, just by tapping them out. All the way down. Go through each one. Maybe a little bit of a darker color. And do this in here. Tap that in. Kind of where the palms all come together. In that area. Now we'll come in the palette knife and we'll get some white to highlight those trees. A little roll of paint. Come in and tap this. Tap that where that light would be hitting it. And we'll take the little fan brush and pull from that just with the corner. Kind of give that circular. Circular look. had some white up here. I think I like some white on that edge. Look. On the palm tree. Circular motions. We're just pulling it from the dark. Okay, let's add some greenery down here. So we're going to go into liquid clear, this 2-inch brush, go into some green color, green and brown, green and brown, black. A green color going. Just like that. Now we can come in and tap some things in here. Greenery. Just like that. You got all kinds of little light stuff happening already. You really didn't have to do anything. But I'm going to go ahead and go into some yellow. Yellow and some white. turn some stuff in here. Hello? Hi. Okay. Okay, thank you. Okay, bye. Just keep putting it in wherever you think. Just like that. Blender brush. We'll tap this down here. Have it sit right in. All the little dark areas back and through the. But not too much. I like to leave some of that in there. Maybe that comes right down. Just like that. Makes it soft right underneath that tree. Maybe we can put some nighttime seagulls. Have the silhouette coming into some black on that fan brush. Maybe they're back over here. You can do them in threes. Maybe there's one up here. Maybe that one is closer. Tell you what, I'm not too keen on this one. So let's take them right away. If you don't like it, take it away. You can make it a little bit darker back that way. Okay. come into that brush again. And we'll put another one in right here. Well, I think we can call this a completed painting for a nighttime version. I'm going to sign this down here. And in some liquid clear. Always sign your last name. That way people know who you are or who painted it. And I always like putting the year in. Let you know your progression, what you were thinking at the time. Well, I hope you enjoyed this one of Moonlight with the ocean. I hope you're painting along with me. I hope to see you again. Bye.